Hey, my name is MRSHL, and here's how I made my song Depths out now on Neoluminum. So starting off in the intro, we have some chords. This is a Labs choir layered with some French horns. The main melody consists of two things. This one is an arp and a music box, which both are flex presets. You'll find a lot of flex presets within this project. Flex is just very useful. This guitar is a flex preset layered with an FL stock plugin, I believe. These drums are a mixture of some FL stock samples I found and some drums I recorded myself. This is just another choir in the background. A cheesy flex bass. Riser. Moving on to the build-up, I dragged in some claps. I also teased the main bass, and I'm automating the cutoff as the buildup progresses. Some weird glitchy sounds to fill in the background. Then we have our extra stuff like risers, snares, hi-hats, and kicks, and it all comes together to make this. This main bass actually comes from a different project I have. So initially, this sound came from a DNB kind of track. But I was thinking, you know, it wasn't going too well, so I kind of just repurposed it and slowed down the tempo to 105 and just changed it on the automation. Now for how the sound was actually produced. It's basically a square wave with a ton of processing. You can see the detune is being automated. Then the sine fold distortion cutoff that's also being automated. Just a bunch of multi-band compression and a notch filter. Now for the actual effects, I added some chorus to the high end, some distortion, then this multi-band delay kind of thing, which kind of acts like a disperser. I also added another filter, and some more EQing, and some reverb swells. Then I exported it and dragged it into this project. I also chopped things up and reversed some stuff. The drums are also pretty simple. There's also some fills as the song progresses. This falling sound in the background, I believe, is an old sample that I have. if you go on my channel, there should be a video on there that has this very sound. Then onto the break section, we have the French horns again with the new strings. I also added this weird rhythm bass that pans to the left and right. Just a basic Reese with the cutoff being just slightly automated. These guitars are a mix of an FL stock plugin called FL Slayer and another Flex preset. I'm also automating the cutoff more than in the rock section here, just to give it more impact. These drums, you're not gonna believe it, these drums are a Flex preset. They're also layered with the same FL cymbals. This is the same bass preset that's in the intro here. In the second half of this break, there is also a very distorted lead. Then just for the funny, I just got this two extra bars before it goes into the buildup. This sound is a laser put through a granulizer. I'm automating the wave spacing and also automating the comb filter cutoff. This buildup is practically the same thing as the first buildup, it's just in straight tempo instead of swing. Now onto the second drop, it has the same drums as the first one, just arranged differently. This is just a basic super saw. This main melody has lots of layers. This mid bass is a patch I made a while ago. It's basically a saw FM'd by a pad wavetable. The very thing that gives it this distinct tone is the sine fold distortion. Just a basic sub bass with noise. There's also this sounds in the background, which is a Flex preset. How surprising. And it all comes together to make this. This main bass is just a variation of that basic bro step lead you would hear. And some weird sounds to fill in the background. Cellophone, square sustain, and the same dink sound, if you will, that you hear in the first drop. These are just chants to fill in the background. And this little square thing is supposed to be a layer for the snare. More fills. And this is the sound I find really cool. So if you take out all the processing here, and pitch it back up, it's just an exported sound of me just going pitch down 12 semitones set to the E2 generic mode. Then we get to the effects. Some frequency shifter. This wave shaper thing that just makes it really crunchy. Some vocodex. Comb filter. OTT, saturation, and some stereo enhancer to give it some more width. Then just to round it all off, we have the slowed down version of the main melody. There's some weird sounds, guitar. So that's basically it for the whole breakdown. If you haven't streamed In the Dark EP yet, go do it. If you have already, go do it again, I don't know. And thanks for watching.